I spoke to him, sir. Or you should be getting ready to complain, or complaining, and all of a sudden the Spirit will speak up some scripture, something that should jog your memory to think about Christ. This is what Paul the Apostle, he wanted every opportunity to encourage. Now, I'll put it out on your side. How much are you encouraging people that are around for Christ? This is tough sometimes because, you know, I notice I'm a big family, and sometimes we can be talking and for majority of people, it's probably some show. During football season, it's football. Or during basketball season, it's basketball. I was with some preacher one time, and I thought we were going to have a spiritual conversation. He says, are you into basketball? And I knew where he was going to go. He wanted to talk. And there's nothing wrong with that, per se, but there should be some time that we can talk scripture and character change outside of just coming to Ebenezer. Paul the Apostle was about a life change. Very important. Go ahead, Diane, the next one. What are the two things that he preached? Repentance. What is repentance? The literal meaning is to turn around, turn away. So we preach repentance via Jesus Christ, right? You got to know that you're a sinner. Got to know that you messed up, and that's why you're saying, God, forgive me. I messed up. And there is no hope for me without Christ. That is the crux of the gospel. That's what Paul the Apostle preached over and over again. It wasn't get wealthy. It wasn't get a bigger house. It wasn't have more clothes. It wasn't anything about that. It was about repent. For the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Not saying that God won't bless you, but his predominant focus, which all of our focus should be, is repentance and faith, this whole process. Look at that next one. It says, repentance is an about face by which the sinner acknowledges his lost condition and bows to God's judgment as to his guilt. What we've said, you got to know that you messed up.
Yes.
We're in a society that really people don't consider themselves messed up. They consider it a life choice. You know, this is just the way I am, and it's okay. I'm not hurting anybody. But you very seldom will see people, I messed up. Confessions. We're in a Mr. President Bill Clinton society. And I'm going to explain myself because this is just written on my brain. I remember years ago when he got caught up in that scandal, that sex scandal and everything, and he came on, he interrupted. A good show was on that night, he interrupted. President Logo came up, and he says, I want to let y'all know, I did not touch that woman. Right? Yeah, you're right. I did not. I was like, see, he remembered it. I did not have that with that woman. And he was so sincere. He was so sincere in that, but his definition of what sex was just all killed. Later on, we found out, yeah, stuff that was going on. But the repentance is, you know what? I would have a liar's face came on and said, you know what? Guys, I messed up. I messed up. I had a lack of character. I'm guilty. I'll do whatever I need to do to work this out, but I have failed the American people, at least when it comes to this level of morality. But you don't hear that too often. You know what? I don't even expect it from our world leaders, but I do expect it from our spiritual leaders.
Amen.
How often do you hear that? most of the time it's just accepted in lifestyle, and people know it's wrong, but nobody says the same. Paul the Apostle wanted to make sure that we have this whole process of repentance, turning away from our sin. To be saved means there is a change. Not that we're perfect, but there is a change. We should be different from our unsaved friends. We just should, because Christ dwells on the inside of us. Look at that next part. Faith is commitment of oneself to Jesus Christ as Lord and